Gash.
Is it true what I heard? That you broke that glamour and ripped that place of your soul?
Anybody ever heard of a colossal monster with a forest growing on its back? Because I got some samples.
Mine.
That's a Mi'kmaq. In Huron Indian folklore, it's some kind of minor deity.
It was covered head to toe in those damn leeches.
That means we found yet another blood factory set up by Debano and Felicity.
That would explain why they attacked Baxter. They were protecting their source, the ancient blood they used to transform their familiars.
Bad news is this Mi'kmaq thing was supplying their war for quite some time now, allowing those foul bloods to spread all over the country. The good news is, they won't do it anymore.
Step aside. Even if he doesn't kill us in our sleep, that link in his head will lead the Tix right to us.
Then let them come. Killing Tix is what the Rentier Institute does.
You listen to yourself? This isn't about your birthright. This is what happens when we run a government agency like a goddamn monarchy. All our protocols go out the window as soon as Daddy Dearest...
Keep talking to me about the rules, you bureaucratic shrew.
Please, we're all on the same team, remember?
Only when it suits him. How about finally telling me where Edgar went?
He's in Maurepas, searching for the plant to make the regen compound.
The regen compound? Now you're wasting what little resources we have left chasing a fairy tale?
Listen, Mr. Gravener's an experienced agent. If he didn't have faith in his mission, he wouldn't bother. We are at war, Doctor. Who else is worth saving if not the leader of the Institute? And in the long run, it could help everybody if the thing by some miracle actually works.
You have until tomorrow morning. In the meantime, your father will be restrained and placed under round-the-clock supervision.
Fine. I'm gonna get Edgar's ass out of those swamps. And if I get back with that plant and I still see that shotgun in your hand, you better damn well prove you know how to use it.
You picked a strange time to assert yourself, Virgil. Why'd you back Jesse's quest for this ridiculous compound?
Just because the scientists at the manor didn't find anything? Doesn't mean there isn't something there. I mean, did they ever let you take a look?
No.
We have a habit at Calico of making the impossible happen, Doctor. I fixed Mr. Jesse's gauntlet, made it better even. Scott found the best lead we have with those leeches. If anyone can make that compound work, it's you.
Oh. Those are Edgar's. Must have found that plant here. I'll take that. The trail leads this way. Christ, wish I had a map of this place. That sounds like trouble. Something broke the boat, but it looks like you managed to escape. Must have been in a hurry if he dropped his damn crossbow. I'm sure Edgar wouldn't mind if I took advantage of this little beauty. Thank you. Nothing alive here except those freaks. Finders keepers. Money. This whole place smells like death. Jesus, who the hell would want to set up camp here? Road clear. Blood everywhere in one big-ass spider web. I hate spiders. Mine. twisted and... That eight-legged freak was hunting him down. Guess this is that giant arachnid's lair. He's not wrapped up like a mummy in a web. Guess he got away.
Thank you.
let's stick to the facts. Bloom researched vampiric legends. A lot of myths and hoo-ha about some sort of plant. One that could allegedly reverse the process of the change. It's considered an affront to the purity of the royal blood.
Ominous. But can it work? From a biological point of view?
Now and then, some of those legends contain a grain of truth. An endemic species like this may have peculiar properties. If researched properly, some cell mutations, I don't know.
Imagine how many people we could save if you made it work.
Look, I'm not a miracle worker, Virgil, but I'll give it my best shot.